Hi there, I'm Gregg with Sonnax, and today I want to talk to you about the quickest and easiest way to do rear band adjustment checks on drag racing, turbo 400, and 4L80-E applications, and that's with the Sonnax externally adjustable rear band servo system. As you can see, this cover has the pin and the adjuster coming through the cover. That's what's unique about it and makes it easy for anybody to adjust the band. So most people are running a stock style cover, which is this right here. And there is no way to adjust the band unless you remove the cover. And then down inside here is the piston and the pin. And to make the adjustment, you have to either change or adjust the pin length. And that takes special tools to do all the checking. And then you have to put the original cover back on. And if you have a stock style valve body, that means the valve body has to come off as well. So it's just not practical for most people to do this as part of their periodic maintenance on a drag racing transmission. And for that reason, the aftermarket has come along with various different styles of adjustable servos. And this particular one has a removable nut here, and it allows you to get down inside there, and you can adjust the band without removing the cover. But you still have to get down inside here, and it makes it difficult to tighten and get the tools in there, and you have to go through the adjustment process just to check the band. So here at Sonnax, our team thought that there should be a better way, and that's what we've come up with, making it just as simple as any Power Glide or 727 band adjustment that's out there. And that is with this extension on the piston. And this extension has the adjuster on it, and the adjuster comes right through the cover. So without removing the cover, you can do the adjustment process, and it makes it easy for anybody, including racers, to do their band adjustment check, make sure the transbrake is working consistently, and if you're at the track going around, you can race with confidence and know you're not gonna have any problems. So what's all this fuss about checking the rear band on a 400? Well, best way to illustrate it is with a story that we've all heard in some fashion or another about somebody that, you know, gets to eliminations or finals, and they get up to the line there, and all of a sudden their transbrake doesn't hold, and they have to foot brake it while they're running some of the fastest cars on the property, and usually that doesn't go very well. And that's because the band has gone out of adjustment and the transbrake doesn't hold. And you know, with a stock type vehicle, the rear band adjustment is a set it and forget it type thing. You set it once, and for the life of the vehicle, it's usually good. But in a drag racing application, the band can get a lot of abuse. That's holding for your trans brake, and when you're bumping in, that's releasing and replying, and it can get stretched out. And, you know, if you blow the tires off on a line or something like that, the drum can spin up, burn the band, cause some wear, and now your servo piston is going to be traveling further and it needs adjustment. So the rear band is what wraps around this drum. And it's kind of like just a belt around the drum. And then the servo piston pushes on the band just like a buckle on a belt, so to speak. And it tightens this band around the drum and holds the band in place. And that's a key part of the transbrake action, because what we're trying to prevent here is, in the case, there's only so much travel that the piston has. So the piston goes in the case and it travels. And if it bottoms out, if that piston bottoms out in the case, well, then it's no longer clamping the band. So a lot of it's like, I think of it like checking your valve adjustment. You know, you go through the last check procedure. You're not always adjusting things. A lot of times you're just checking things to look to see if there's a bigger problem. And that's where the real value is with this externally adjustable servo. It allows you to quickly check the band adjustment to make sure that there's not a problem. So when you get up to the line, your transbrake is going to work and you won't be that guy foot braking it. So let's get into what it's like to work with this servo. So you have your pin, which threads into the cover, and the lock nut goes on here, and then that goes through the cover. And it installs to the case in a very conventional way, not a lot different there. The little bolts that hold it to the case, though, we ask that you tighten them all down and then back them off a half turn before retightening them. Just helps make sure the cover is centered. And then from there, we have our adjustment procedure, which is very typical of a Power Glide or other applications. You want to back off on your lock nut. You have your torque wrench set at 72 inch pounds. And we do include the torque spec right here on the cover. So if you're at the track, it's an easy reference. And So you would go through the torquing and making sure your nut is free and tighten this down until you get your torque value right there. And then you just want to back it off three turns, which is one, two, three. And from here, you just need to tighten it up. And there you go. So from there, you know, just like when you're building any other 400 4L80, we can do an air check. So we're going to come in here. And one thing I want to point out is this little silver area right here that's sticking out from the cover. It's sticking out about an eighth of an inch, and that approximates your piston travel that you want. So as we air check it, you're going to be watching this silver part go down flush with the blue. And that represents a properly adjusted band. And that little feature is going to have additional benefit when we put the valve body back on, and that's what we're going to show you next. Okay, so we have the valve body back on, and now I want to demonstrate the number one benefit and the key point to this whole servo system, and that is how quick and easy it is for you, the racer, to check your band adjustment. And that can be at the track or between races, wherever it may be. You don't have to rely on your transmission guy anymore to make sure that your transbrake is going to hold. So if you have the pan off, we can get access to this. All we have to do is push in on this and see that the silver part goes about flush with the blue part. And I'm going to demo that here with a little pry bar. And as you can see, that band is properly adjusted, right? Now, if it went in deeper, that would indicate there's some wear going on, and you would need to go through the adjustment procedure, which we demonstrated. It's very easy. And once it's readjusted, now you know your trans brake is going to hold, your piston's not going to bottom in the bore, and when you get up to the starting line, you won't get caught with your band down. So what we've just shown here is new and never been available before, but I do want to talk a little bit about something that's been kicking around out there, and that's this. And this is a modified OE steel cover where somebody's welded a nut on here with a little adjuster and a lock nut. And that adjuster is pushing on the end of the servo, adjusting it deeper in the bore. And that really is not the proper way. It doesn't solve the whole problem that we're here for, and that problem is to make sure that the transbrake holds. And it stops working, the transbrake stops holding when the piston bottoms out in the bore. And if the piston bottoms out in the bore, it's not applying the band and holding your transbrake. And this, the only proper way to adjust the servo is by having a longer pin. That's the way the OE does it, and that's the way we do it with our adjustable pin. And with this system, by adjusting the piston deeper in the bore, doesn't solve that problem. So watch out for these. With that out of the way, last thing I want to do here is go through the kit and show you in detail some of the parts we have. Okay, so we have two kits, one for the 400 and a separate one for the 4L80-E. What they have in common is the highest quality billet aluminum parts for the cover and the piston. And one of the things about the piston is the protrusion here actually takes away a small percentage of apply area from the center of the piston where that comes up through the cover. And that, I think it's about 4% of the apply area. But when you factor in the oil pressure that's reacting on there, it ends up being the equivalent of a change in just a few PSI in line pressure. And obviously these things work over wide ranges of line pressure. So giving up that small amount of apply area is inconsequential, and we get a real big benefit of having that piston come through the cover here. They also share the hardened ground pin, so a very durable piece there. And then the differences in the cover, obviously the 4L80 has a different bolt pattern, and that uses a conventional gasket to seal to the case. Whereas the 400 has a little extra room here, and we're able to squeeze in this O-ring that goes in the cover, does not use a conventional gasket, and then this seals positively right to the case, and it makes it very easy to service as well. And then the 400 version also includes the bolt hardware. It's also a low profile design that's intended to clear a stepped pan. So if you're using one of these pans, this will go right on. You won't have to modify anything. And again, that just points to ease of installation, ease of use. So if you're a racer who's considering an upgrade to your servo, or you're concerned about your transbrake working, or if you're a builder that wants to put highest quality features out there in the units you build, Sonnax has got you covered with another highly engineered product that works and provides great value for everybody. So if you want any more information on this part or any of the other parts we have for these units, check out our website or feel free to give us a call. We'll answer any questions you got. Thanks for watching.